Today I am going to tell you that whatever we assume, any attitude, we always reach the opposite. The expected is never achieved. The desires never be fulfilled. The longed for never achieved. And the more you desire it, the more you lose it. Because desires never can be fulfilled. Ichha hu akash sama anantiya. The desires are like the sky, cannot be fulfilled. Like the sky cannot be fulfilled, desire cannot be fulfilled. Whatever the dimension may be, it makes no difference. The law remains the same. If you ask too much of anything, you are going to lose it, just merely by asking. Like, for example, if someone asks for love, he or she will not get love because his very asking of love makes you unlovely and ugly person. Because the asking makes a barrier. It creates a barrier. No one in the world can love you if you are asking for the love. Because by asking, nobody can be loved. And if you don't ask for anything, it makes you beautiful, makes you very much relaxed. It is just like I give an example. If someone closes the fist, and by closing the fist, the person is thinking, what I will do, that I will possess the air in my fist. But the person doesn't know. The lie is, the more he closes the fist or she closes the fist, it loses the air. Only love can be possessed, or only air can be possessed by open hand, because air is there. But the people, they try to close the air, close the fist more and more and more, that maybe the all air is now tightly possessed in my fist. But it is the opposite. The more you close your fist tightly, more tightly, all the air will slip from there. And you cannot hold the air in your fist. What will happen? That even a person will try to close even more tightly, that maybe I will hold the air inside the fist. And that's what people need to understand. That is the absurdity of the mind. That is the trick of the mind. Trick of the mind is that you make the fist to hold the air, but you don't know that you are going to take all the air out by closing the fist. But mind does it that. But that is sure that you cannot hold the air because of closing fist. And people begin to think, oh, maybe they are doing something wrong. That why they cannot hold the air. Maybe if someone begin to think, oh, you are closing the fist wrong way. That's why I cannot hold the air. That's why it cannot happen. Remember, if you love someone, person become possessive. And when person become possessive, a person begins to close in. The mind might say, because mind is very, very tricky, it might say that try to be even more, even closer. And they try to make an effort. But somewhere there is a leakage. That is who love is being lost. That is why the love is being always lost. Only with open hand you become the master of the air. You become the master of everything or every happening. So it is like you are not closing your mind. When you don't close, non-closing mind, can love become a flowering? Only by non-closing mind. Then, and it can happen with everything. It is not just by love. It can happen with everything. You have to apply this law everywhere. So if you apply it and you will find it, what is the real principle? to be flower, to be blossom. The more you long for life, the more you expect, you lose it. Because by expecting, you reach always opposite side. You become like when it is possession come, you become a dead. You don't become alive. You don't become alive. You become a, because the very longing is any kind of longing I am talking, longing for life even, becomes a poisonous. It is very difficult. A person like Mahavira, a person like Buddha, with no lust for life, with no longing for life, lives very, very divinely. And that person flowers into aliveness perfectly and totally. The day Buddha was dying, someone asked him, "You are dying, we were going to miss you a lot." And you know what Buddha said? "But I died long time ago. I died maybe 40 years ago." Because when you begin to understand and you don't have lust for life and you don't possess things, your mind doesn't play trick on you. It becomes non-possessing mind and it becomes fully cooperating with you. So you see the real thing. He said, "I have maybe died 40 years ago. That's what I am alive." Remember, when a person achieved knowing, I am talking knowing, or enlightenment, he lives. He doesn't die. He died on the surface. He died on the outward world, outward. But he lives inwardly. And that is the real aliveness. That's why when someone asked him, he said, "No, I died for a long time ago." Because there is no fear now, fear of death. Fear of death is gone. When you think you have achieved something high, divine, and fear fully is gone, so there is no possession. You become like an open hand. And when you become like an open hand, everything is in your face then. But when you try to close in, you cannot be a master. You want to be a master? Be like an open hand. All the air is there. All the possibilities are there. All the wealth is there. With the open hand, you become natural. You become effortless. And very effortlessness takes you in the real liveness, to the real life, will take you the real bliss, will take you the real ecstasy, will take you the real and total liveness, will take you the real love. Open and all the air is there and you become the master. As soon as you close in, air slips from your face. The more you close in, maybe you will think you are doing wrong thing or something wrong. No. But the fact is that open hand makes you the master of the air. Same way, if you are open, you don't have any tension, you don't have any stress, you don't have anything, and your mind doesn't play trick on you. The absurdity of the mind will be gone and you will be like a nature flowing, open-handed. So if you don't want to lose it, don't possess it. Let it be open, like open hand. All the air is there. Close in, air will slip, like you're trying to possess. And possession, anything of possession, everything possession, you're going to lose it. No matter it is things, no matter it is person, no matter it is your children, no matter it is you, or you, no matter whatever you have with you, going to lose it. It's better to be, to have, to be open hand. All the airs are there, all the possibilities are there. Keep it, all the possibilities there. And when all the possibilities there, you might be achieving enlightenment. You might be achieving the real, the reality, the truth. And you're never going to lose it. Om Shanti. Om Shanti.